Hey, what's up everybody? Today I'm going to be showing you how to port your phone number to Google Voice.
After clicking the link in the description below, you'll be taken to this page where you can port or transfer your personal number to Google Voice. There's a couple different options for doing so. We're interested in option number one. So click on that and you'll see here that you can check your porting status on this page. Go ahead and click on that. After entering your phone number, hit the checkbox and you'll be told that you can or cannot. In this case, we can. So there's a couple different things to know before porting your number to Google Voice. The first is that it costs $20 to do so, which I feel is very cheap for something of such great value. The next thing, and this one kind of scared me, it says your mobile service plan will be terminated when you port your number to Google Voice. So this you have to be careful with. I was a little worried because I had a family plan and I wasn't sure if the whole family plan would be discontinued or not. The case is that they only removed my number from the family plan, so you don't have to worry about anything like that. And I wasn't under contract, so there was no early termination fees. This third point here says that you will not be able to receive calls to your mobile number while you are doing the porting process and until you complete two additional steps. The first one is you have to set up a new phone number. This is going to be the number that you're porting forwards to. So practically what this looks like is going to your cell phone provider, in my case it's AT&T, and asking them for another phone number once your original number is removed from your account. Once you do that, you can forward your Google Voice number to your new phone number and it'll be set up and good to go. Number four, Google says you might not be able to receive text messages for up to 3 business days after the porting process. I did not see this happen to me. I immediately saw the text messages coming through right after the porting was complete. Moving right along, if you already have a Google Voice number, which you probably do, it says that that's going to be replaced by the number you're porting. That makes sense. And you also have the option of purchasing your old Google Voice number for another $20 fee. Finally, here, you just have to click this box that says you understand the risks associated with porting your number. Honestly, there really aren't that many risks, so go ahead and click that box and do the phone verification on the next screen. The phone verification step is simply Google trying to verify that you own the phone number. So what Google's going to do is call your cell phone and you're going to have to type in the number that they present to you. In my case, I had to type in 65 on the keypad of my phone. As soon as that's complete and Google verifies that you're the owner of that cell phone number, you'll be taken to the account information page. And this is where you're going to input all of your information from your current carrier. In my case, AT&T is my carrier. And you just have to enter your account number, first name, last name, billing address, all that stuff, and any PIN associated with that account. So that way, what Google's gonna do is actually go into your account on your behalf and remove that number, probably in an automated manner. And then once you have all that information inputted correctly, you'll see this final page and you'll make the payment, the $20 to do the porting. That takes a couple seconds, as you can see on the screen here. And once you do that, you're actually good to go. You have initiated the Google Voice porting process. And for me, this whole process took exactly 24 hours. Actually, it was 24 hours and 1 minute. I initiated the process on a Friday at 9:38 p.m. and it was finished and complete on Saturday at 9:39 p.m. So it was really quick. Now, if anybody's interested in why you would ever want to port your phone number to Google Voice, let me know in the comments below. I specifically have done this because I wanted to keep my cell phone number, which I've had for well over 10 years now, and use it overseas when I'm traveling. That's just one of the many benefits of Google Voice. As long as you have an internet connection or some type of data connection, whether that's through your cell phone service provider, a local SIM card, or just on Wi-Fi, you can use your cell phone number on your phone, on your computer, on your tablet, whatever. So let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. Thank you guys for listening. I will see you guys next time.